Hello everybody, welcome to my third C++ tutorial. Like I said earlier, in this week's tutorial, I'd like to show you some of the fun stuff you can do with what we've learned. But first, I need to show you how a random function works. So I'll start by creating our main function. And then inside our main function comes our custom code. And our code, I want our code to start by creating a place where you can store this random number. So we'll call this variable rn for random. Now, we want to store our random number into this random variable. So we write random number is equal to random 5. In this case, I want to store a random number between 0 and 5. And note that it does not include 5. So these are the possible numbers that can go into random. Note that 5 is not included because random returns a number between 0 and the number passed to the function. And in this case, the value we passed is 5. So 5 will not be included. Now, we want to output the value generated onto the screen so that you'll know how this random function works. So we'll output and our random variable and finally endl, which is all we explained in the previous tutorials. Now we want the value to stay on screen and we don't want it to close immediately, so I'll add a getch. And note that our computer, just like you didn't know a few seconds ago, doesn't know what all these functions mean, so we need to include our header files, which is again all been explained in the previous tutorial. Now, so I include iostream.h, which basically explains cout and the rest of our program, and also hash include conio.h, which explains getch, and finally hash include stdlib.h, which explains our random function. Now, when we run the program, hopefully there's no errors, and yes, there's no errors. It did generate a random number between 0 and 5, and in this case, it was 1. Now, we want it to generate more random numbers, so it'll look more random, and so you'll believe me that it is really a random number. So I copy and paste the code a few times so that it'll keep generating a few more random numbers. Now, in the first case, the random number was 1. When I strike a key, the getch function works, and then it'll go to the next code, which is our next random number, which is 3, which is also a number between 0 and 5. Next comes 0, then comes 1, 4, and you get the point. Now, when I run the program again, you'll notice that it is generating the same random numbers over and over again every time I run the program. But it is random and it is between 0 and 5 because you can see they're all different and they're all random, but they are the same random numbers. Now, how to make it generate different random numbers every time you run the program? Luckily, C++ created for us, so we don't have to go deep into it. We just have to write random eyes function. And again, you don't need to pass any parameter to it because it doesn't accept anything. If you do, it'll come out as an error. Now, when the program runs, it'll generate random numbers every time you run the program. 30014. This time comes 002300. And as you can see, it's all random numbers every time you run the program. Now, since you know how random functions work and how randomize works, I can finally show you how our guessing game will work. Now, how does our guessing game work? It'll first generate any random number it wants. So let's start typing our code. Now, how do we want our guessing game to work? Well, I want it to first generate a random number and then ask the user to guess it for me. If the user guesses too big, then output "you entered too big." Or else, if the user guesses too small, then output "the user entered too small." And so get the user to keep on entering different values until the user finally gets it right. And if the user gets it right, then output "you entered it right." And finally, halt the program on the screen so that the user has time to read it. Oh, and also remember to add our randomize function. Otherwise, the user will know the answers, like if you close and reopen the program again. Now let's try running our program. Let's guess 1. Well, it's too small, so 10. It's too big. How about 9? That's too big as well. And 6 is also too big, so let's try 3. Well, that's too small. 4, okay, too small, so 5. It's gotta be right. And yes, it is right. So congratulations, you've just created your own game in 5 minutes. I hope you liked this video. And if you did, please help me out. Put a thumbs up, subscribe, comment, tell me where I went wrong, where I can do better next time, and maybe even request program for you. Anyway, thank you for watching. Goodbye.